What's up guys, my name is Joe and today I want to talk about the best hairstyling process for thick hair and thin hair. I'm not saying the process is the same for both, rather I've got a great process for thick hair and a separate great process for thin hair. We're going to cover both of them in today's video. And this process has mostly to do with the pre-styling process, so before you blow dry your hair and while you're blow drying your hair, and also the products that you're using. So let's go ahead and talk about the main difference we're going to explore today, and that is shine for thick hair and matte finish for thin hair. And I'm going to be demonstrating both for you so you can actually see that visual representation here in this video. First, let's talk about the problems that we're trying to solve. When it comes to thick hair, all day volume and that filled out look, that's not a problem. What is a problem for thick hair though is making sure that your hair doesn't look overly poofy or like too block shaped, almost like a helmet. Like a helmet head effect. Getting some good texture and some natural looking soft separation, those are the main struggle areas with thick hair, and also trying to control that poof. Thin hair on the other hand has no problem with naturally soft looking flow, hair laying down in natural ways that look nice, and also hair that is easy to manipulate. The issues with thin hair though is that it can be hard building in long lasting volume, making sure that your hair is staying up, and depending on how much hair you either have or don't have, it can look like you're starting to thin even more, and there's also that issue with some visible scalp sometimes, which, you know, guys with thin hair, they just don't like. It makes sense. So with thick hair, we're wanting to create all day texture, natural flow, and being able to control that poof. With thin hair, we want to create the perception of having thicker hair and also figure out how to have all day volume. And really, to put it simple, this comes down to shine for thick hair and matte finish for thin hair. So let's go ahead and talk about it. Now, as I'm sure many of you guys already know, I've been on that matte finish hair journey for most of this channel's life. And even though I'm liking some more shinier styles, I'm not talking about like overly shiny or that greaser look. What I've been doing recently is actually pre-styling my hair, because I do have thick hair, in a way that adds shine. So this means using more cloud control than usual. I normally recommend with starting between 2 to 4 drops, but for me, in order to add a little bit more of that control, I'm going like around 7-8 drops. Then I've been going in with Fifth Sample Pomade, which I've found to be a fantastic pre-styler for thick hair types especially. It helps to add a good amount of hold and control, but because of the slight shine factor, it really keeps the poof under control and makes the hairstyle as a whole just look so much more streamlined. Remember, our pomade is the most shiny product that we have in the Bloomon line, but it's still a very tame shine, especially compared to a lot of other pomades out there on the market. Now check out this next bit. I'm blow drying my hair the same way that I normally do. It is a bit of an updated blow dry technique, so I might bring this to a video soon, but I'm starting out with hot air to reposition my hair in the way that I want it to go. By the time I finish blow drying my hair with hot air, I'm not sure how well this comes across on camera, but my hair looks more shiny than I would like. It almost looks a little greasy, but this isn't the end result. I always finish off with cold air, so when I switch to cold air and blast through my hair one more time, all of a sudden that oily shine from before dies down a lot. It still has some shine, but in a way that looks really nice with thicker hair types. My hair looks healthy, and most importantly, it's starting to have some nice defining texture, and it's not too poofy, and this is all in the pre-styling process without adding a post yet. From there, you can either add more Fifth Sample pomade, this is a great finisher as well, or what I've been using recently that I actually never expected to like, it's the Firm Clay from Suavecito. It's funny because this product is technically not a great clay because it's too shiny, but for the purpose of what I've been wanting to go for, it's been working out great. Thicker hair guys out there, you're looking for a clay with some shine, even though it doesn't say it has shine. It does have some shine, and it works out great for thicker hair types. So I take a scoop, again, going with the semi-shine finish theme, and throw it in. I find that this combo, or using Fifth Sample pomade again, is a great way to keep thick hair under control all day long with a healthy glow and good texture, and your hair is not going to start getting fluffier and fluffier throughout the day, which if you have thick hair, you know that that is a common struggle to have. Just getting poofier and poofier as the day goes on. I kept the style that you're seeing here all day and recorded towards the end of my day for you to see the results. And as you can see, I've still got plenty of volume, separation, and control with a little bit of healthy shine. Thick hair problems fixed. You got that volume, you got the separation, you got that texture. It's looking great. Check, 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 check. And guys, I mentioned Fifth Sample, so if you wanna try Fifth Sample or any other product from the Bloomon line, we are officially coming out with the Bloomon Discovery Kit, this bad boy right here, on September 25th. The whole point of this is in the name. You get to discover the Bloomon products. You get to have all 5 of our styling products, as you can see, beautifully packaged,
Oh my gosh.
It's in a nice, easy, travel-friendly box. I'm really happy and proud of the team with what they came up with because I think it looks great. So if you either want to be able to test out all five, then this is a great option. Or if you want to be able to switch up your hairstyle, go for something a little different depending on the occasion. This gives you all the products to switch up your hairstyle as often as you want. Definitely keep a lookout because this guy right here, the Discovery Kit, is dropping September 25th. Speaking of things that are dropping, let's go ahead and talk about thin hair remedies. We covered thick, let's talk about thin. I'm showing this on myself just to show you guys the difference between the thin hair and thick hair results. Obviously, this is for thinner hair now. This time around, I didn't use any oil to get any shine or anything like that. Instead, the only thing I threw in my hair was the upcoming volume cream, which is gonna be called Ascend, by the way. Ascend Volume Cream, okay? Get it in your heads? It's a great name. Ascend Volume. Get it? Okay. And this has been specifically designed for guys with thinner or finer hair types. Don't get me wrong, it's gonna give me some serious volume, but you'll see why it's for thinner types here in a second. It's matte finish with no shine, and it thickens your hair up as you start blow drying it down, which is perfect for thinner hair types. When I finish blow drying, you'll notice that my hair looks pretty good, but I'm not getting that same flow and texture as the previous method. Again, flow and texture is not an issue for guys with thin hair, so this isn't a problem. Also, just remember that hair always looks good right after blow drying, so the real test is later on in the day. I finished off with some Monarch Matte Paste, which is a lightweight paste that I usually recommend as well for people with thinner hair types. And then I just went about my day. Again, what's important to remember is that with thick hair, I'm not gonna have a problem maintaining volume throughout the day. So I'm not trying to show you that I had volume with one hairstyle and lack of volume with the other, because I had a good amount of volume with both hairstyles. The issue that I'm gonna have, as you can see from these clips at the end of the day, is that my hair is more blocky looking and dry as opposed to the previous method that we used for thick hair. The thing is though, like I said, thin hair naturally has soft flow. So repeating this method on thin hair will give you that thick, volumized look and feel while still allowing for that natural soft flow that you're naturally gonna have as a thin haired guy. And another reason why shine isn't usually friends with thinner hair types is because shine just adds to the separation and can make your hair look even thinner than it is, and it can also cause increased scalp exposure. So generally, you know, thinner hair types, you wanna stay away from shiny finished hairstyles. Unlike thick hair, which can actually benefit from that shine, soaks in and controls your thick, poofy, frizzy mess. I hope that was educational. I'll keep you guys posted on the release for the volume cream. It's the best volume cream that I've ever used. You can really feel it activating in your hair as you blow dry it down. I think you guys are gonna be super impressed and I can't wait to get it out there. For now, the Discovery Kit is September 25th. That's just in a few days away. Thank you guys for watching. Hope you found it helpful. Give this video a big thumbs up and I'll see everybody next time.